We all are aware of the term aircraft carrier. In basic terms, they are just an airfield floating at the ocean on which airplanes can take off and land. Unlike other naval vessels, these carriers are vital for a country's navy to showcase its dominance over airspace at the sea. But did you know that the first true aircraft carrier with a deck capable of launching and landing airplanes was built by the British Navy? In this video, we shall learn about the history and the significance of an aircraft carrier for a country's navy. Let's first learn about the history of the aircraft carriers. During World War I, the British Navy developed the first true carrier with a flight deck, the HMS Argus. It was built on a converted merchant ship hull. The war ended before the Argus could be put into action, but the US and Japanese navies quickly followed the British example. The first US carrier, a converted collier renamed the USS Langley, joined the fleet in March 1922. A Japanese carrier, the Hosho, which entered service in December 1922, was the world's first commissioned ship that was built as an aircraft carrier, unlike the previously mentioned modified carriers. Aircraft carriers became the dominant combat vessel after demonstrating their potential in the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor on 7 December 1941. They also played a leading role in the battles of Midway Island, Coral Sea, and Leyte Gulf. The aforementioned aircraft carriers used steam turbines for propulsion, and the first nuclear-powered aircraft carrier was the Enterprise, launched by the United States on 24 September 1960. Now, a question about the need for the carriers arises. An aircraft carrier is needed to project domination and adds to the military power of a country. All the world's powerful countries, the United Kingdom, the United States, Russia, and China, operate aircraft carriers. Aircraft carriers provide a major advantage in terms of air support. Aircraft carriers can easily launch and recover aircraft at sea, allowing them to provide air support anywhere in the world. This is invaluable for both offensive and defensive operations. Besides, the aircraft carried by these carriers can be launched very close to the shores of an adversary nation and can plunder the assets. In times of hostilities, an aircraft carrier can bring hundreds of stranded soldiers. It can be of great help during disaster scenarios for humanitarian operations. Now, if we classify aircraft carriers based on their displacement, i.e. the weight of the carrier when it is loaded with fuel, weapons and other supplies, we arrive at four types. Light aircraft carriers, displacement between 10,000 to 25,000 tons, medium aircraft carriers, displacement between 25,000 to 45,000 tons, heavy aircraft carriers, displacement between 45,000 to 75,000 tons, and super aircraft carriers, also called as super carriers, having a displacement between 75,000 to 1 lakh tons. The HTMS Chakri Nerubet, belonging to the Royal Thai Navy of Thailand, is the world's lightest aircraft carrier, with a full load displacement of 11,486 tons, and the US's Gerald R. Ford, belonging to the United States Navy, is the heaviest aircraft carrier with a full load displacement of 1 lakh tons. The construction of an aircraft carrier is a time-consuming process and requires a larger amount of investment in resources and expertise. Hence, these carriers do not sail alone. The carrier operates as a part of the carrier strike group that usually include guided missile cruisers and destroyers, attack submarines, supply ships for food and fuel, and may also include other support vessels. Moving to the next and the final part of this video, how are fighter jets launched from these carriers? Currently, CTOBAR and CATOBAR are two different launch systems used on aircraft carriers to launch fighter jets. CTOBAR stands for Short Takeoff But Arrested Recovery. This launch system uses a short runway on the carrier's flight deck and a ramp at the end to provide additional lift to the aircraft during takeoff. CATOBAR stands for Catapult Assisted Takeoff Barrier Arrested Recovery. It uses a catapult to launch the fighter, providing a more powerful and controlled launch than the STOBAR system. Both the launch systems use a set of arresting cables to slow down the aircraft when it lands on the flight deck. There are two main types of catapult systems used on aircraft carriers: steam catapults and electromagnetic catapults. Steam catapults use steam pressure to power the launch, while electromagnetic catapults use a linear induction motor to accelerate the aircraft along a track. If you find this video interesting and informative, please make sure to subscribe to watch more interesting videos.